Hey guys.
Hey Bo.
Hi Bo.
Flippin' physics.
Ladies and gentle people, the bell has rung, therefore class has begun, therefore you should be seated in your seat, ready and excited to do a basic example problem about acceleration and to understand a little bit about the direction for acceleration.
Ready.
Set. Go.
Okay, here we go. Billy, please read the problem.
Mr. P is riding his bike at negative 14.3 kilometers per hour when he begins pedaling the bike to cause a constant acceleration. If, after 6.4 seconds, the bike is moving at negative 23.7 kilometers per hour, what was the acceleration of the bike?
Can you show that again, please? That happened pretty fast.
For you, Bobby, yes. Great, now let's translate the problem to physics. Billy, if you could please read again, and Bo, could you please do the translation?
Mr. P is riding his bike at negative 14.3 kilometers per hour when he begins pedaling.
Please stop. The velocity initial is negative 14.3 kilometers per hour.
Pedaling the bike to cause a constant acceleration. If after 6.4 seconds the bike is moving at negative 23.7 kilometers per hour, what was the acceleration of the bike?
The change in time is 6.4 seconds. The final velocity is negative 23.7 kilometers per hour. And acceleration equals question mark because acceleration is what we're trying to find.
Bobby, what next?
Well, we learned last time that kilometers per hour and seconds don't match very well, so let's convert both of the velocities to meters per second. We know there are 3,600 seconds in an hour, so multiply both velocities by 1 hour over 3,600 seconds to cancel out the hours. And we also know that there are 1,000 meters in 1 kilometer, so multiply both velocities by 1,000 meters over 1 meter to cancel out the kilometers.
And what do we get then for numbers for velocity initial and velocity final?
I actually have both answers. The initial velocity is negative 3.972, and the 2 is repeating. And the final velocity is negative 6.583 with a repeating 3.
Great. And Bo, what should we do now?
Again, we start with the equation.
The equation.
Yes, the equation. Acceleration equals the change of velocity over the change in time, where the change of velocity is equal to velocity final minus velocity initial. Once we have the whole equation written down, we can just plug in all the numbers because we have the numbers, and we get negative 6.583333 minus negative 3.972222. That whole quantity divided by 6.4.
Yes, it is that simple. And what do we get for numbers?
That worked out to be negative 0.4079861, with 2 sig figs, that'd be negative 0.41 meters per second squared.
Yep, we get negative 0.41 meters per second squared, 2 sig figs because of the 6.4 seconds.
Questions?
I have one.
Actually, I have one too, but you can go first.
Oh, thanks, Bobby. In the video, the velocities weren't actually negative. Why not?
Well, yeah. Good eye, Bo. You're talking about the number shown on the bike, right?
Yep.
Well, okay. Billy, what is the name of the item on the bike that is showing the number 23.7 kilometers per hour?
I think it's called a speedometer.
Correct. We're reading that 23.7 kilometers per hour and the 14.3 kilometers per hour off of the speedometer on the bike. Notice a speedometer, not a velocitometer. And a speedometer, not a velocitometer, or whatever it would be called, displays just the speed, not the velocity. So in this particular case, it's giving us the magnitude of the velocity at that particular time. So the magnitude of the velocity at this particular time is going to be the speed and not the velocity. Now, we do know it's negative because I'm moving to the left in the video.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense, thanks. Bobby, what was your question?
My question had to do with the fact that the bike is speeding up. And if the bike is speeding up, shouldn't the acceleration be positive?
I thought that negative accelerations meant that you were slowing down.
Oh yeah, the direction. I guess we should talk about that. It is in the title of the video. First off, realize that we did do the problem correctly. We should end up with a negative acceleration even though we're speeding up. And let's talk through why that is by way of some examples.
Okay.
Good.
Let's do that.
Okay. Let's say by way of an example that I'm riding my bike to the right and speeding up. In this particular case, that would mean that my velocity would be to the right and my acceleration would also be to the right, and both would be positive because they would be to the right. If instead I'm riding my bike to the right and slowing down, my velocity again is going to be to the right and positive. However, my acceleration is going to be to the left and negative.
Oh. In other words, when you are speeding up, the acceleration is in the same direction as the velocity. And when you're slowing down, then the velocity and acceleration are in opposite directions.
Exactly. If the object is speeding up, that means that the velocity and acceleration are both going to be in the same direction. However, if the object is slowing down, that means that the velocity and acceleration are going to be in opposite directions. Which means, if I am riding my bike to the left and speeding up, then because I'm riding my bike to the left, the velocity is going to be to the left and negative. And if I'm speeding up, then my acceleration is going to be in the same direction as the velocity, which is going to be to the left and negative. If, however, I'm riding my bike to the left and slowing down, that means that my velocity is still going to be to the left and negative. However, because I'm slowing down, the acceleration is going to be opposite the direction of the velocity, and therefore the acceleration is going to be to the right and positive. Now, I do think that that bears repeating and writing down on the board. Again, if the object is speeding up, the velocity and acceleration are in the same direction, and if the object is slowing down, the velocity and acceleration are in opposite directions. Let's take one more look at the four examples because, darn it, it took me a long time to film. Any more questions?
Nope.
No.
Thanks.
Actually, I'm a bit surprised that there aren't any more questions, because if you look at our acceleration, this is our answer for acceleration. However, it doesn't have a direction, and acceleration has both magnitude and direction. Unfortunately, because of the problem statement, we didn't know enough to be able to figure out a direction from the problem. I kind of did this on purpose because you're going to run into problems where you are not given a direction, and alas, you can't actually figure out a direction in your answer, and this is what you're going to need to do. So I thought it'd be good to go through an example like that, although in the problem they probably should have said something about direction so that you could figure out the direction for your answer, because again, acceleration has both magnitude and direction. There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, people, I enjoyed learning with you today. I hope you enjoyed learning with me.
Lecture notes are available at flippingphysics.com. Please enjoy lecture notes responsibly.
You can both film at the same time.
Yeah!
Hold this.
I don't know how to work this one.
So, it's the same one. So move forward, stand about here, and I want you to film what Mommy and I are going to do.
So, do you hold it like this?
Yep. Well, you can see what you're filming.
I can't get the whole car. When do I press record? It is recording right now. I'm filming you. Why are you not supposed to be? I'm not filming. I don't know how. I got some video. When do I press record?
So what I'll do is I'll yell 3, 2, 1, break. So we're gonna, I'll go over to the other side. So we're gonna do the same thing, only I'm gonna be on this side of you now. Why don't we head back? I'm gonna take some wearing the chest harness.